AI is revolutionizing the way that we write code, and there's nothing more evident about that fact than GitHub Copilot. It's groundbreaking. GitHub Copilot has been trained on millions and millions of lines of code from all sorts of programming languages and repositories. It is your virtual coding teammate, helping you write code faster by offering insightful suggestions that save you tons of valuable time. I am Jeremy McPeak with EnvatoTuts Plus. In this video, we will use GitHub Copilot to write an application from scratch, and you'll see firsthand how it can identify patterns in your code and significantly cut your development time. But first, if you're ready to take your applications to the next level, then look no further than Code Canyon, the ultimate marketplace for developers and programmers, featuring solutions for web development, mobile apps, e-commerce, and so much more. Explore, build, and transform your project with the unmatched resources available on Code Canyon today. GitHub Copilot is a fantastic tool, and I think that it is one that most developers would reach for because it is a pair programming experience. Basically, that means that as we are typing our code, Copilot is going to offer suggestions. Copilot is not free. The cheapest plan is $10 a month. However, that's cheap if you find that it provides value to you. There is a free trial, but you have to create a GitHub account and you have to provide a payment method. The trial, I think, is 30 days. And after the 30 days, if you don't cancel, it's going to charge you. But I highly recommend that you give Copilot a try, especially if you write code for a living. Now, Copilot in and of itself isn't going to magically do anything. You have to install an extension for your code editor, which there are extensions for a variety of code editors. I don't know them off the top of my head because I typically use Visual Studio Code. So you install the extension, you have to sign in using your GitHub account. But once you do that, you are ready to start using Copilot. Now, in Visual Studio Code, there is an icon in the bottom right-hand corner of the screen. This will tell you if you are signed in. It will also tell you if the extension is activated or not. So we are going to look at a couple of different ways of how we can use Copilot. And the first thing to do is just to start writing code. Because as you add some code and then you go to a new line, it's going to start prompting you with what it thinks you want to do. So here I've added a doc type. On the next line, it's prompting us to add an HTML element, which of course we want that. So I'll hit tab, I'll hit enter, and then it's going to prompt us to add a head element. Now, we don't have to stick with whatever it is prompting us. There are other options. If you hold down the Alt or Command key and then use the bracket or the square bracket keys, then it will cycle through different options. So here there's only two options. One includes a link element for a style sheet, the other does not. I don't plan on creating a CSS file, so I'm just going to use the version that doesn't have that. But notice that the title here is Calculator, and it probably got that from the name of the file, which is, of course, calculator.html. Now, another way that you can use Copilot is with comments. I want to add Bootstrap to this file, and we can see here that as I started to write a comment, Copilot is prompting me to add Bootstrap. So if I hit tab there and then enter, it's going to link in Bootstrap, but this is assuming that I have Bootstrap, which I don't. I want to use a CDN. So what I can do instead is say add Bootstrap. And then on the next line, it should prompt for a link element that pulls in Bootstrap using a CDN. This is version 3, but that's going to be fine. So if there's something specific that we want Copilot to do, we can specify that inside of a comment. And that comment is really dependent upon what language we are currently using. Since I'm using HTML, we're using HTML comments. If we were using JavaScript, then we could use JavaScript comments. So if we wanted to write a calculator object, then that's what we could put in our comment and it would start generating some stuff. But we'll get to the actual JavaScript here in a few moments. All right, so we have our head elements, we need our body, and let's just start defining our UI. So we're going to use a container, but this container is going to be the container for the entire calculator application. So I'm going to give it an ID of calculator container. And then the first row is going to be the display of our calculator, which is going to be an input element. It will be a text box. And let's give it a class of form control. Let's give it an ID of display. And then the next row is going to start our buttons for the numbers and the operator. So a typical calculator would have 7, 8, and 9 for the first row. And we can see that this wants to generate a row that has some operators, such as clear, backspace, divide, and multiply. I don't want that, so let's see if there's any other options. I'll hold down Alt or Command, and then press one of the square bracket keys, and that changed our option. So this is more along the lines of what I want. However, it's not exactly what I want. I don't want to use an on-click event handler. I want to use event delegation. So I'm going to delete most of this, and I'm going to change this one entry for the number 7. And what I'm going to use is a data attribute. In this particular case, we'll just say data value. We'll give it the value of 7 because this is the button for 7. And that's it as far as this button is concerned. So let's start with the next button in this grid. And we can see that Copilot is prompting us almost exactly the same thing, except that the value of 8 is being used for this button, which that is exactly what I wanted. So we will close out that div. It will then prompt us for the 9 button. And then we should have an operator. And in this case, it wants us to have division. So that's going to be fine. There is something different that I want to do here. Instead of data value, I want to use data operator. That way we can know if we are dealing with a value or we are dealing with an operator. I also want to change the class here. Instead of the button default, I want to use the button secondary so that our buttons will have different colors. The number buttons will be default, the operators will be secondary, and then the clear will be a different color as well as the equal sign. So this is our first row. This is what I want to use as far as the pattern is concerned. So let's go on to the second row. And Copilot is going to prompt us with an interesting set of HTML. Notice that it is following the same pattern. So the numbers have data value, the operators have data operator. Notice that the class for the button is secondary for the operator. So Copilot knows what is inside of our file. It knows what patterns to identify, and it will start using those patterns in its suggestions. So for the next row, once again, the numeric values have a data value attribute, the operator has an operator attribute, and the operator uses the secondary class. So we should have another row that would have the equal sign, the 0, and other things. And sure enough, Copilot is suggesting that as well. There are some changes, though. The equal sign is an operator, so I want to give that the data operator, and the value will just be an equal sign. Everything else is going to be okay, but notice what it did for the equal sign. It automatically added the primary class there. So that's really awesome, I think. So let's take a look at this in the browser. Let's refresh, and that needs to be squished together, but that's a good start. We do need a clear button, and let's do this at the very top. Let's do this directly underneath the display. So we will have our display, then we will have a row for the clear button. And let's see what Copilot gives us. Well, there it is. Now it thinks that we might want to have parentheses and the percent, but I don't. Let's just stick with a clear button. Let's do this though. Let's use the data operator attribute and we'll just say C there. But notice the class. It used the danger class. So it knows that this is the clear button and that it needs to be a different color than everything else. And it needs to stand out so that we know, hey, this, you might want to not click this. So that's perfect. The only other thing is that we need some style to make this look a little bit better on the screen. So we could add a CSS file because it wants us to add an external CSS. Instead, I'm just going to have a style element. But notice, it is prompting us selectors that are relevant to our document. So calculator container with a margin top of 50. Display with a margin bottom of 10. Let's give the container a width of 300 pixels. That way it will be a little bit easier to see on screen. That's great right there. Something else though, the display needs to be right justified. So let's set the text align to right. And let's see if it's going to prompt us for anything else. So after the display rule, let's just hit enter. Let's see what it says. Button width 100%, margin bottom 5 pixels. I think that would look great. It does. Let's see what else it's going to offer, which doesn't look like anything. I hit enter twice, which is habit for me. But it doesn't look like it's going to offer anything else for our style, which is fine. I think that looks great as is. So we can now focus on our JavaScript. Now, I already have in mind how I want this to work. It's not going to be the safest thing, but what we will do as we click on these buttons, it's going to add those numbers to the display. And it will do the same thing for the operators. So if we say 1 plus 2, then in the display, we would see 1 plus 2. And then whenever we click on the equal sign, it's going to eval that expression. And it's not going to be the safest thing, but it's going to work in this particular case. And so I want to use object-oriented programming here. So I want a calculator object. So let's just start with calculator. Let's see what it's going to offer us. It thinks that we're going to want methods for add, subtract, multiply, and divide, which I don't want. First of all, though, we need to get the elements that we want to work with. So we need our container, which it wants us to use query selector. I want to use get element by ID. And that's almost it. We just need to say calculator container and it's popping up right there. That's awesome. Display is now coming up and that's almost correct. We just don't have the calculator dash in front of it. But then we have, let's see what else. It wants buttons. I don't think we need that. Instead, all we really need are three methods, one called add number, which will accept the number. And then let's see what this is going to prompt us. Append that to the display. That's exactly what I wanted. And then we will have an add operator, which is essentially going to do the same thing, but we want to take into account that an operator might be equal sign or clear. And we will get to that here in a moment. But then we will have calculate. And this method should just eval the value of the display. So let's see what this is going to generate for us. And it doesn't look like it's going to generate anything, which that's a little disappointing. But let's just start typing. And sure enough, that's exactly what I want to do. Eval the display value and then set the result to the display value. That's perfect. So as far as our add operator, let's check to see if the operator is equal to C. Well, it's prompting us there. And let's see what this is going to prompt us to do. Just clear. Let's do this. We will set the display value to an empty string. I don't have to type just a few keystrokes, and then it's going to prompt me with exactly what I want. Which, of course, this is a simple thing to do. But the fact that I'm able to just type a few keystrokes, hit tab, and then that's almost the functionality that I want. That's perfect. Okay, so this is our calculator object. All we need to do now is set up the event delegation for the click event. And look at what it's doing. Calculator container add event listener. This is so awesome. So let's see what this is going to prompt us. This will be interesting. So we want to get the target. If the class list contains number, if it contains operator, let's look and see what other options are there. I don't think any of these, well, that's close. In fact, let's run with that because we don't use a class list. Instead, we have the data attributes. So really, no, we don't even need to do that. We could do something like this. If the target dataset operator, then we know that we have an operator, so we're going to call add operator, passing in that operator, and then we will just simply return. If it's a number, then our dataset will have the value property, in which case we will call add number, passing in that value. And that is so awesome. Didn't have to write but just a few keystrokes, and then it's filling out everything else. And this is all that we really need to do for this method. We could make it a little bit cleaner like this else if. That way we won't have to have the return statements there. But that is the functionality that I was after. We can go back to the browser. Let's refresh. And as I press 1 plus 2, none of that is working. So we have an error somewhere. Oh, you know what? I didn't add that JavaScript file to the HTML. That's kind of important, isn't it? So at the bottom here, add in that calculator.js to our HTML. Let's go back to the browser. Let's refresh. And now all of this should work, but there's a reference. Target is not defined. What is that? Oh, yes. I got rid of the target variable. So we will add that back in. Copilot just automatically prompted it for us. So 1 plus 2 equals 3 plus 9 should be 12. Let's clear it, and we're good to go. Now, we could have created this application using ChatGPT, but it would have taken us quite a few prompts, and even then, we really wouldn't end up with what we wanted, because you never really get exactly what you want. You can get something close, but eventually you have to take it and then make whatever changes that you need to. But using GitHub Copilot, well, we just had to write the code that we wanted to write, and it just started offering suggestions that fit right in. And I don't know about you, but this is definitely a tool that I will use on a daily basis. Thank you so much for watching. Please like this video if you found it helpful, and be sure to subscribe to the Envato Tuts Plus channel so that you won't miss out on any of our new and fantastic content. I'm Jeremy, and I will see you next time.